In 2011, a macaque monkey nabbed a wildlife photographer's camera and took the first ever primate selfie. But who owns the photo? According to photographer David Slater, he does. And he's considering taking legal action against Wikipedia, who are refusing to remove the image. But Wikipedia says that Slater doesn't own it because the monkey took the photo. Welcome to the wonderful world of intellectual property, where you can find yourself in court over the ownership of such weird things like the words,
let's get ready to rumble!
A phrase owned by boxing commentator Michael Buffer, who's made $400 million licensing his catchphrase to ads, toys, and video games. So unless you have stacks of cash, don't be too vocal about your readiness for rumbling.
I like to hope that on nights that I've said it, some kid that's pulling out of a parking lot with his dad says, you know, remember when that guy said, let's get ready to rumble and everybody went nuts?
And if you do get sued, don't publish a tell-all book entitled,
Don't!
Homer's expletive was trademarked by 20th Century Fox in 2008. But it can go both ways. Even fictional characters can come under fire for ripping off other characters. Recently, the creator of True Detective was accused of plagiarizing nihilistic dialogue from writer Thomas Ligotti. Nick Pizzolatto said the character was not based on one author, but many philosophers.
I think human consciousness was a tragic misstep in evolution. We became too self-aware. Nature created an aspect of nature separate from itself. We are creatures that should not exist.
Although curiously, he doesn't deny ripping off every bong-smoking pretentious roommate you've ever had.
We are each somebody, when in fact everybody's nobody.
Speaking of depressing, why doesn't anyone ever sing Happy Birthday on TV or in the movies? Because the song is owned by the Warner Chappell Corporation and no one wants to pay for the rights. Even though some people dispute this copyright, until it's resolved, it's safer to sing something else at your next party. Sure, copyright's designed to protect creations, but it doesn't mean you have to be a dick about it. For example, the golden record on the Voyager 2 spacecraft had songs chosen to represent the best of Earthling culture. When scientists suggested the Beatles song, Here Comes the Sun, record company EMI said no. Extraterrestrials could make pirate copies to sell at their intergalactic cash converters. So who owns the monkey selfie? Well, probably not the wildlife photographer, and unfortunately not the monkey either, because non-humans aren't allowed to hold copyright. So arguably, the photo's not owned by anyone. And I know what you're all thinking. How can I shoot this segment and show all of these trademark soundbites, music, and TV footage? Fortunately, I'm not the one actually shooting this video. Isn't that right, Chairman Meow?